on the ground. The Bible says that he has put the enemy under your feet. So when you get up in the morning, stamp your feet for the enemy to know you are awake. So it's not your body size that matters. It's what is on the inside of you. You may be small, but let the fight be on the inside of you. Rise up with some fire in your eyes.
And the Lord was saying to you, look at this generation. It's a generation that's upright, a generation that's given to worship. I'm not going to allow this to be abused. I'm not going to allow this to be taken unanswered. I'm going to answer that prayer. I'm going to come back and reward these people. They have given where they've had no money. They have sold when they've had no ability. They have cried and drained every tear. They have dug wells and never found water but kept on going. I'm preaching to a generation in Accra, Ghana, of young men and young women that are not corrupt, that are looking towards the hills for their salvation. It's a generation of the upright. I want you to put your hand of strength on your head and shout, Lord, I'm here, three times.
When you start focusing on that clear, laid out vision, you become like a mighty magnet. You start to attract it down to your life. Because what you have written, which you think is just a vision, is absolutely already in existence. Just that it's in existence in a dimension of spirit. That's why the Bible says, he calls the things that be not as though.
That's a generation of revelation knowledge, a generation that's looking for more, a generation that's looking for answers, a generation that will not rest, a generation that's looking for solutions, a generation that will not take no for an answer, wants an answer to the why that's asking why, a generation that's refusing to be denied, a generation that will keep on pushing, a generation that knows how to sacrifice but knows how to dress up right.
The greatest thing that is going to happen to the world is coming from Africa. I believe that Africa is the next big thing to happen to the world. Africa must position in a certain way to be able to manifest what God is about to do through you and I on this continent. You are designed to be a success, and there is no way you can fail, because when you were supposed to fail was when you were just a spermatozoa, when you didn't have a mind, when you didn't have an eye, when you didn't have a voice, but yet still you beat over 500, oh my God, million potential human beings. Say, I am a success. Say, I am a success. Understand that the sky is not your limit. You are your only limitation.
So whilst they are crying in Egypt, God is answering their prayers in the land of Midian. One more time. Whilst they are crying, praying in Egypt, God is bringing an answer in another place. Somebody, you are crying in Ghana, but your answer is coming from Dubai. You are crying in Ghana, but your answer is coming from China. Maybe you are crying in Accra, but your answer is coming from the northern part of Ghana. God is answering somebody's prayer right now. Shout, I believe it. Get ready. The Lord told me to tell you, let my people go. Whatever your family members could not do, the Lord told me to tell you, let my people go. Most of the people in your family have not been able to own any business since the inception of your family. But get ready, I see a new generation of people who are about to enter into the face of the family and tell the family, say yes, the Lord, let my people go.
Destinies are never the same. We can come from the same family, but our destinies are never the same. The moment you understand this lifetime principle, you will never ever compare yourself to anybody. No matter how anointed you are, when it comes to sexual temptation, 1 Corinthians 6, he said, you got to flee. So don't say, oh, I'm going to pray and stop it. Madam, Mr. Man, you got to be careful. Because guess what? I am born to make impact. Once you know that you are destined to make impact, you will not mess up with some things. Listen, shout impact. Come on, I can hear. Shout impact. Shout it louder. Shout impact.
The word of God is something that every child of God here must have in them, so that in times of trouble, you find the word in you. Did you hear what I said? It's not every time that you call your pastor to help you pray. You have to have the word in you. So when enemies are encamping against you, you find a scripture in the word that will get you out of the problems. Like the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yet though I walk through the valley of the shadows of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thy preparing a table before me in the presence of my enemy.
It's different. I like to keep the shot.